Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Shinya Tashima from Japan Breast Pathologist. I am honored to take part in this Congress. Now, I would like to present about nuclear inverse polarity papillary lesions lacking myoepithelial cells. This paper was indexed in PubMed. No conflict of interest is seen. Now, I would like to introduce myself. 2001, I graduated Keio University School of Medicine, received training in Department of Pathology at Keio University. 2008, Department of Radiology at St. Mariana University School of Medicine and get PhD. Research about breast imaging and pathology. 2013, Department of Pathology at St. Mariana University School of Medicine. Research area, radiopathological correlation of breast cancer and molecular biology. Next page. St. Mariana University School of Medicine located west side of Tokyo about 2 hours in train. Very rural. But breast operation number is number one in university in Japan. My wife is radiologist and co-researcher. I love her. And I like photography, and I am also a photographer. I like film cameras. I like slow lifestyle, so I choose film camera. And I am good at peeling in the kitchen. Preface. Breast health is important in the world. In Japan, it is said that one person for 11 people diagnosed breast cancer. Hence, early detection of breast cancer and healthy lifestyle is important. Because in Japan, it is thought that healthy food is relation to prevention of breast cancer. Now, I would like to present about difficult breast introductory lesion, which is benign. In present case, almost all pathologists misdiagnose malignant lesion. However, my opinion is benign and indexed in PubMed. Hence, accurate pathological diagnosis is important. Here, we present two cases of benign intraductal lesions. Introduction. Apocrine papillary lesion with loss of myoepithelial cells was first reported by Cerny et al. And reported that this type of lesion is a benign lesion. To the best of our knowledge, no reports have described non-apocrine papillary lesions lacking myoepithelial cells that are benign. In this report, we present two cases of non-apocrine papillary lesions with no myoepithelial cells. We characterize these lesions using immunohistochemistry and analyze the clinical features of the lesions. Diagnosis of a breast papillary lesion is sometimes difficult because papillary lesions can exhibit a broad range of histological features, such as B benign intraductal papilloma, atypical ductal hyperplasia, ductal carcinoma in situ, and encapsulated papillary carcinoma. Recently, some reports have described the use of immunohistochemistry for discrimination of benign versus malignant lesions. The utility of estrogen receptor, ER, and high molecular weight cytokeratins, including CK56, are reported. Additionally, the usefulness of MAC3 was suggested by Raka et al. And Furia et al. Furthermore, Furia et al. Reported the application of P63, MAC3, ER, and CK56, along with the use of the differential index, DI, to distinguish between benign and malignant intraductal papillary lesions. These targets was performed in the present study. Sadik et al. And Seo-Fun et al. Reported that immunostaining for the cell cycle marker of cyclin D1 may be useful for discrimination of benign versus malignant breast papillary lesions. Thus, we also evaluated cyclin D1 in the present cases. The cell growth marker T67 can be used to determine the grade of malignancy and for prognostic evaluation. We believe that the T67 index provides important information regarding the nature of papillary lesions. Therefore, we performed T67 staining in this study. Finally, we also evaluated the disease-free interval following surgery in each of the present cases. Material and methods. Paraffin-embedded sections measuring 3 to 4 micrometers thick were deparaffined. Antigen retrieval was then performed for 20 to 40 minutes in boiling water, 95 centigrade, containing citric acid solution, pH 6.0, or target retrieval solution, pH 9.0, Nichirei Tokyo, Japan. pH 6.0, Dako, Glostrup, Denmark. Sections were pre-treated with 0.3% peroxide and reacted with primary monoclonal antibodies against ER, CK56, T67, MAC3, cyclin D1, collagen 4, and myoepithelial markers of P63, calponin, SMA, and CD10. Subsequently, specimens were incubated with a secondary antibody, histofine simple stain MAX4, Nichirei, Tokyo. The chromogenic substrate was Giaminobenzidine, DAB, and the slides were counter-stained with hematoxylin. We used the following formula described by Furia et al. Based on the total score for ER, CK56, P63, and MAC3 immunoreactivity to calculate the differential index as follows. Differential index is equal ER total score plus MAC3 total score per cytokeratin 56 total score plus P63 63 total score plus 1. The cutoff value was set as 1.0. Scores less than 1.0 were classified as benign. Clinical manifestations. Case 1. A 68-year-old woman had an abnormality that was detected during a medical examination of her breast and came to our hospital for further examination and treatment. Ultrasonography revealed an intraductal papillary proliferative lesion measuring 2 cm in diameter. Due to the large size of the lesion, malignancy was not excluded. Then partial mastectomy was then performed. The patient was followed up for 62 months with no further treatment and exhibited no evidence of disease. This is clinically benign because 5-year follow-up. Clinical manifestations case 2. A 44-year-old woman felt a palpable mass in her right breast and came to a hospital for further examination and treatment. Ultrasonography revealed an intraductal papillary lesion measuring 2.5 cm in diameter. Core needle biopsy suggested that it was suspicious for malignancy, so malignancy could not be completely ruled out. Then total mastectomy was then performed. The patient was followed up for 74 months with no further treatment and exhibited no evidence of disease. This is clinically benign because over 5 years follow-up. In the case 2, comparatively low echoic mass with blood signal is seen. This red is blood signal. Then I would like to present ORED score. What is ORED score? For assessment of immunohistochemistry results, papillary lesions were assigned an ORED score. For the assessment standard, one of 6 proportion scores, PS, based on percentage of positive cells, was assigned, and one of 4 intensity scores was assigned according to the staining intensity. The proportion score scale was 0, 0%, 1 less than 1%, 2, 1, 2 less than 10%, 3 more than 10%, 2 less than 33%. Score 4 over 33% to less than 67%, and 5 more than 67%. The intensity score scale was 0, negative, 1, weak, 2, intermediate, and 3, strong. When the two scores are combined, the total score ranges from 0 to 8. For Ki-67, MIB-1, the labeling index was estimated from the percentage of reactive tumor cells among at least 1,000 tumor cells. Cyclin D1 immunopositivity was calculated using the same method. Pathological findings. Case 1. HC sections showed epithelial papillary proliferation with inverse nuclear polarity, absence of nuclear tibia, lined by fibrovascular core, and lack of myoepithelial cells. Myoepithelial markers of P63 and calponin were completely negative, and also myoepithelial markers of SMA and CD10 were negative. Total ORED score for ER, CK56, P63, and MAXI were 0, 8, 0, and 4 respectively. Therefore, the differential index was 0.44. This is benign. Cyclin D1 immunopositivity was 0%. This was benign. And the MIB-1 T67 index was less than 1%. I think this is benign. Pathological findings, case 2. H staining showed epithelial papillary proliferation with inverse nuclear polarity, absence of nuclear atypia lined by fibrovascular core, and lack of myoepithelial cells, similar to the observation in case 1. Almost the same case. Myoepithelial markers of P63 and calponin were completely negative. Total ORED score for ER, CK56, P63, and MAXI were 0, 2, 0, and 2. Therefore, the differential index was 0.67. This is less than 1, so this is benign. Cyclin D1 immunopositivity was observed in approximately 70% weakly positive cells. This is intermediate to malignant. And the MIB-1 T67 index was 0%. This is completely negative. This is benign. H and E low magnification view of case 1 and case 2. Both lesions are papillary lesions. Intraductal papillary lesions. And at a glance, intraductal papilloma. But no myoepithelial cells was observed. Intraductal papillary lesion is seen resembling intraductal papilloma. But in HE high magnification view, case 1 and case 2, nuclear inverse polarity is seen. This is highlight of this tumor. This is basal surface. This is apical surface. Nuclear inverse polarity is seen. And case 2, this is basal and this is apical. Nuclear is pointed out apical surface. Nuclear inverse polarity is seen. This is a specific feature of this lesion. And calponin, case 1 and case 2, completely lacking myoepithelial cells is seen. But staining is good. Staining is good, but completely lacking myoepithelial cells is seen. Case 1 and case 2 also estrogen receptor negative. Cytokinin 14 focally weakly positive. Hence, malignancy or benign is not concluded. Then we tried differential index and cyclin D1 score and T67 index. Estrogen receptor case 1 total score 0 plus 0 equals 0, total score 0. Case 2 total score 0 plus 0 equals zero. Site question 5-6. Case 1, total score is 5 plus 3 equals 8. Strongly positive. But case 2, total score 1 plus 1 equals 2. Weakly focally positive. P63, case 1, total score 0 plus 0 equals 0. No myoepithelial cells. Case 2, total score 0 plus 0 equals 0. Completely lacking myoepithelial cells. Maxi, case 1, total score 2 plus 1 equals 3. Case 2, total score 0. Cyclin D1, case 1, 0%. Case 2, 70% weak positive. MIV-1 index, T67. Case 1, less than 1%. Case 2, 0%. Results. Taking into consideration of the results, these two regions are considered to be benign. Discussion. Apocrine papillary lesion lacking myoepithelial cells was first reported by Serena et al. Subsequently, Tram et al. Reported that this type of lesion is benign. Notably, Tram et al. Presented a thorough discussion, including a description of the relationship between luminal cells and myoepithelial cells. In the present cases, complex immunohistochemistry and histological results made a clear diagnosis difficult. Case 1 exhibited a differential index of 0.44, cyclin D1 immunopositivity of 0%, and T67 index of less than 1%. Moreover, clinical follow-up has been 62 months with no further treatment and no evidence of disease. Thus, although the tumor lacked myoepithelial cells, case 1 was thought to be a benign lesion. Case 2 follow-up was 74 months with no further treatment. This is clinically benign. The DI and T67 index of case 2 suggested a benign lesion. However, the cyclin D1 immunopositivity suggests a potentially malignant nature. Notably, although both cases showed similar histological features, cyclin D1 immunopositivity differed between them. Based on the overall results, case 2 could be described as a tumor of uncertain malignant potential, but clinically benign. The lack of continued disease progression after long clinical follow-up supports hypothesis that this issue may be benign. Accordingly, we concluded that the two present cases with nuclear inverse polarity papillary lesion lacking myoepithelial cells were not malignant tumors, but benign. Hilson et al. Recommended staining for both P63 and calcium for detection of myoepithelial cells. Because HC staining is not sufficient, in the present cases, myoepithelial marker were completely negative, lacking myoepithelial cells. Tram et al. Describes the interactions between luminal cells and the microenvironment, including myoepithelial cells. We believe that luminal cells of inverse polarity may have affected the loss of myoepithelial cells. In the present cases, the inverse nuclear polarity may have affected the instability of the myoepithelial cells. One report demonstrated that myoepithelial cells function as a structural barrier that plays an active dynamic role against progression to invasion, and that they express tumor suppressor genes. The present cases may have had the potential for phenotypic or functional alterations of the myoepithelial cells. Conclusion. In conclusion, we experienced two cases of nuclear inverse polarity papillary lesions lacking myoepithelial cells and were identified as benign. Thus, the lack of myoepithelial cells did not indicate malignancy. Future comments. Then, taking into consideration of things, it might be thought that there is a breast papillary lesion between non-invasive and invasive lesion. We think that it might exist middle stage between in situ lesion and invasive lesion. In the future, the report of breast lesions lacking myoepithelial cells which behave as benign will be increased. By the way, the name of nuclear inverse polarity papillary lesion with lack of myoepithelial cells is too long. Then I want to give it the name Tajima tumor. Thank you for your attention. Please come to Tokyo next year for Olympic Games. We will invite and welcome you. Thank you very much.